Millions of people on this earth use computers every single day, and don't even know the science behind it. Today we'll take an exploration through computer science, and see many different perspectives on how it works and what it is.
Okay. Computer science is the study of how computers work.
It's a branch of engineering, in which you learn more about software, hardware, both of it.
I think it has to do with a lot of coding, and writing algorithms for solving different types of problems.
The study of how computers work and how we can make them run better.
I think it's the science of computers.
About 11 years old, my father bought a personal computer, and this was, you know, back in the 80s when personal computers were just sort of hitting the market. And he sat me down, and within about 20 minutes, I knew exactly what I wanted to do. I absolutely fell in love with computers, and really enjoyed the programming in them and debugging them, and actually, it turns out later, to build them. And that passion has carried me throughout my entire life. It's only within the last 10 years, after I left a professional research organization and became a professor, that I really understand how much I really love teaching. One of the best ways to reinforce your own passion is to show others and share it with others. I taught a little bit when I was in my PhD program in the late 90s. Where I really started my formal teaching was actually at the Stern School of Business at NYU in New York City. I was working for a company called Bell Labs, which is one of the cradles of computer science. I have to say my favorite part of teaching and research is the sense of renewal. One of the great things about being in this job is that every fall is brand new, and I have new students coming in who've never seen this topic before. And while I've probably taught some of these classes 8 or 9 times, it's different every time for me because it's different for them. When I see them engage in the material and get excited about computer science and do things that they never thought is possible, that's where it really provides that sense of renewal, and it keeps me coming back for more. My previous students are now professors at schools like Georgia Tech, University of Oregon, University of Florida, North Carolina State University. I've also had some pretty interesting advances in the careers of some of my students. In fact, a PhD student of mine who just graduated was just hired by Google to basically run the part of Google that takes in new applications for the Android smartphones. He's actually in charge of evaluating the security of incoming applications before they're released by Google to the world. I think you guys in particular are really at a changing in not just the nature of technology, but the changing of life on this planet. Our species has never had the kind of connectivity that we have. We connect with other people on a planetary scale instantaneously. This has just never been experienced, and it's changed everything from our society, from the way people interact, to the way people date, to the way people buy materials. And so computers are really in this, are fulfilling a role in changing our society in ways that we never anticipated.
As a faculty member, a normal day doesn't exist. My days are split between mentoring graduate students, teaching undergrads, begging the government for funding, and carrying out various service activities related to the university. So the job doesn't stop, right? I go home and I think about research, and I think about what's on this board behind me and what we can do next and where we need to go. So it's just it's a continuous process. My favorite part of working in the field of biomedical engineering is the concept that we can affect the lives and the health of millions of people with the work we're doing. Our contribution to biomedical engineering is understanding how stem cells can be controlled by what is essentially a piece of plastic. We're primarily a biological science lab, but we use tools and resources provided by or developed through computer science. For instance, I have this microscope. And this microscope's capable of taking fantastic images and pictures, but the processing of those images and pictures, if they're cells interacting with the nanotopography, all of the back end, all of the handling of that data and turning it into something that's useful to me would be computer science, or would connect through computer science. If we look over here at this goofy 3D printer that's kind of half torn apart, believe it or not, we can configure that device to either make nanofibers or directly print gels or biological tissues. And again, the ability for us to do that, for us to take a 3D geometry and then convert that 3D geometry into what is essentially a series of layers, is another connection back to computer science.
The U.S. government in technology. I have a Bachelor of Science degree in Electrical Engineering from George Mason University. Systems engineer isn't really part of computer science, but it benefits from computer science, whereas computer science kind of develops the capabilities around computers. Engineers implement things using those capabilities. As an engineer, I benefit from the developments in computer science, and systems engineers kind of take a step up above the individual computers and looks across multiple systems to say, okay, this system needs to get information from that one to process it. We want to be sure that they're able to talk together and exchange information securely and just stay in tune with each other to make sure that the entire broader system works. But the way I look at computer science is as the very fundamental development of capabilities at a very low level. The best thing that computers do is they can do things very repetitively and they can do them very fast. The computer technology is constantly, the change is accelerating. When you look back to the fact that they landed a spaceship on the moon in the 60s using slide rules, hardly any compute power, to today that you're sitting there in Pennsylvania and I'm here in Virginia on these tiny little devices. I wouldn't be surprised if come 20 to 30 to 50 years, you start seeing that combination of computer and human.
There are several things that we can get into. Like today, I have, I'm on the hotline phones. So to me, when I hear the word computer science, my brain goes to like the computational part of it or applications. And so how computer science applies to what we do is that, you know, there's all that computation, all the applications, all that stuff, but our job as techs is to make all that stuff work. So it has to work. You know, if a professor logs into a podium like we have up here and the application doesn't work, then we fail. So the deployment, actually sort of the procurement of that application, the deployment of it, the updates to it to make sure that it works, all that stuff's important. And then when time comes to use it, you know, making sure that the information is out there as to this is how it works, this is how you can use it, and using that to further the teaching experience is what I sort of think of as far as computer science.
Without computers, I think that a lot of the things that we take for granted that that require a lot of computation and math in order to complete would be absolutely destroyed. I think that the finance markets, the stock markets would be hindered significantly. Businesses as a whole without the internet, retail industry that's run massive would be, you know, significantly smaller than they are today. I think that health would be much different because humans no longer have access to products such as IBM Watson that can store and compute and go through many, many different types of medicine practices and health practices. And I think that education would be much harder. A lot of education now is coming from the internet, from computers, and it would be much more difficult for someone to go and receive an education on any subject at all without computers or access to them. Java, C++, Python, Swift, Objective-C, C#, Ruby, Node.js, all the web development languages, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, PHP, those are all ones that I'm pretty familiar with. And yeah, I guess that's it. Swift is my favorite.
Why?
I really enjoy developing apps for the iPhone, and I think that when, I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with it, when Apple made the Swift, when Apple made the shift from Objective-C to Swift as their iOS programming language, they really made it much, much simpler to use. I think Swift as a whole is very sweet. It's very easy to look at and understand, whereas Objective-C was funky and slow and just obfuscated everywhere. So Swift is a nice language to have in my tool belt. I like to think of computer science as the application of mathematics to software engineering. I think that there are three very related fields: math, software engineering, and computer science. And computer science is kind of that hybrid. You know, computer scientists are very good at algorithm-based questions. We're very good at developing mathematical solutions to things. But we also have an equally strong ability to program and put those on the computers, whereas software engineers are a little bit more strictly about developing good software systems that are, you know, good for users and good for companies, and mathematicians don't do a lot of programming. So I think that computer science is a very good mix of the two flavors of math and software engineering.
To conclude this documentary, I have one question. What is computer science?